Welcome back to HopeScope. This video is mostly just my tips for you, but I figured to give it some credibility, I should get online and look up some real tips. So I googled caring for your activewear tips, and the first thing that pops up is it's best to wash your activewear by hand.
Oh, that's broken.
Honey, no.
No.
So these are my tips for all y'all that don't have time to caress your leggings in a lukewarm bubble bath and then personally blow dry them with your face. I was trying to go for like an ombre lip today, but it's just bugging me because I feel like it just looks like the middle of my lipstick came off. Welcome to a very special episode of HopeScope. I've been getting lots of requests for this video because people are wondering, how do I keep all of those nice leggings that you bought because of HopeScope from pilling, fading, warping? I have all the answers for you.
Oh! Woo! Will you smell this? You like it?
So say you just got a beautiful new pair of rose-colored leggings. You take it for a wash, and this happens. The good news is this probably will wash out, but it's really nice to just prevent it in the first place so that you don't have to wash it twice. These are some tips to keep your brand new leggings, or old leggings, I guess, from staining and fading and turning colors they're not supposed to. If you buy a brand new item that is brightly colored, I highly suggest washing it by itself, either by hand, if you don't want to waste a full laundry cycle on one pair. But I have ruined a handful of my stuff, and Tyler's stuff, sorry babe, because I didn't do that. If it's a neutral color, you're safe to wash it with other neutrals. Another great tip is after you've loaded your laundry all up, you put a little bit of detergent in, and then you fill the little cup the rest of the way up with vinegar. And I know what you're thinking, Hope, that's gonna make my clothes stink. No, it doesn't, but it helps all the colors from running together somehow. This is what Tyler told me, I don't know, ask him. If you are washing purely whites, add a little bit of baking soda into the detergent rather than bleach because it's a lot less intense than bleach is. Not quite as invasive on the fabrics. So say you got a fresh spray tan and you're looking fly and you really want to show off that spray tan with a pair of white leggings. Don't do that. But if you do, wow, that looks even grosser than I thought. I'm really embarrassed to be showing you guys this right now. The inside's even worse. It's Have No Fear Max Force. It's what it's here for. I swear by this stuff, just spray a little bit of it on the stain before you throw it in the laundry and no more skid marks. Cue stain montage. It's the worst when you're putting on a nice, fresh, black top to go work out in and get deodorant all over it. Have no fear. All you have to do is get a pair of jeans, rub it real quick on the deodorant stain, and it takes it right off. I don't know how it works or where the deodorant goes, but it works. Say you smash your finger between two weight plates at the gym and you get blood everywhere. Cold water is the answer. Say you're doing an outside workout and you get grass stains all over your little bum. One part dish soap to two parts hydrogen peroxide. Use chalk or baby powder on grease stains because I have no idea what you would be doing in your Lululemons that would result in you getting a grease stain, but hey, we all get fit in different ways. The dreaded sweat stains under your arms. Use some lemon juice. Use club soda, milk, or salt to get out wine stains. For all of you that say that you're working out, but really you just wear your leggings to lounge around and drink wine and watch Netflix in.
These are legit tips, they are just not presented in the most legit, logical way. That being said, HopeScope is not responsible for any damages caused by following any of these steps. Thank you.
Maintaining the shape of your leggings is very, very important. The only thing worse than a pair of shrunken leggings is a pair that stretches out. The best way to avoid warping of any kind of the fabric in the seams is to wash everything in cool or cold water. This next one is key for absolutely every aspect of your leggings, and that is not to put them in the dryer. We'll talk about that more later. That is what causes shrinking though. This next category is a huge one. I know that you're all after that perfect pair of buttery soft leggings, but those are the ones that tend to pill. Tip number one for preventing this is actually to use less detergent. The more harsh chemicals that you're using on your clothing, the more likely they are to break down. Another tip is to turn your leggings inside out before you wash them. Some of us already do that. So when you peel them off, they turn inside out and then you're too lazy to turn them right back out. Good news is you don't have to do that. Keep them inside out. It's better for them. So this helps protect the colors, the stitching, and just the overall integrity of the fabric so that they don't pill. This one might sound kind of obvious, but just a friendly reminder not to ever wash or store your nice activewear with anything that has hooks, zippers, wires, or Velcro, anything that it can snag on. No dryers. Especially when it's a polyester or another type of synthetic fabric, those are basically plastic fabrics. The heat causes the individual fabric fibers to break. They then become tangled into little balls. It starts as fuzz formation. You'll start to notice a thin layer of fuzz on your leggings, then entanglement, then growth. Another tip is not to ever wash your leggings with hoodies or towels or anything super cottony and plushy that have a bunch of those little fibers that can get sucked right in. If you have a detergent that has cellulase in it, that actually helps to break down the pills. You can also invest in a sweater comb. You just gently brush the pills off with that little guy. I don't have one because, to be honest, I haven't really had an issue with any of my leggings pilling. Even my Lululemon Aligns. I know. What? Maybe my dryer's just on a low heat setting and I don't know about it. Or maybe God knows how much I have invested in my leggings. Here's something you probably didn't think of. It actually is possible to de-sweatproof and de-antibacterial proof your leggings. This might come as a surprise to you, but you actually shouldn't use fabric softener with synthetic fabrics. It actually removes its ability to be sweat-wicking and antibacterial because it clogs the pores of the leggings. I ran out of fabric softener about a year ago and haven't bought it since. So you know what? Once again, sometimes being lazy is actually more efficient. If you start not using fabric softener sheets and you find that your clothes just get crazy staticky, sorry, I felt like I was just starting to get a little bit low energy there. Don't put a Twix bar in your dryer though. That's not what I was going for. You can actually use a little ball of aluminum foil. Use it over and over and over again. Yeah, I know that this looks like something that shouldn't be safe to go in a heat vortex, but according to the internet, it's fine. I did a lot of digging and nobody has had a dryer blow up on them via ball of aluminum yet. Bonus tip, you can actually throw your shoes in the washer, not the dryer. Heaven knows what'll happen if you put tennis shoes in the dryer. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you found some of these tips helpful, and even if you don't even care about your leggings at all, maybe you found the video entertaining. Either way, give it a big thumbs up before you leave, and we'll see you guys in our next video. Say bye, YouTube!